When your life feels like constant information overload and you can hardly find the information you took note of just a week ago, you need more than just sticky notes and a digital note app. You need an ally to cut through the chaos. Meet your best friend for your wallet and cross-platform Microsoft OneNote. Hey there, I'm Christy. Welcome to this super quick OneNote setup tutorial. After downloading this completely free tool, you don't have to watch the cursor blinking anymore. After opening your OneNote on your desktop, let's navigate the interface. I've also included a workbook for you in the description below, so you can use it and follow along this video or practice the tips shared later on, whenever you want to. When you download the workbook, you'll immediately find some printable keyboard shortcuts, prompt, inspiration, and a sketch page that will guide you through the process of designing your ideal notebook. Hints and tips from this video are also included. When you first open OneNote, it will be empty and most probably the pages will be on the right-hand side. Go to View, Tabs, Vertical Tabs to change this. That moves everything on the left-hand side. That's very close to the view that the other devices like tablets have. I actually like the horizontal tab view on my computer. You can change the look of the ribbon or menu bar if you wish. Go for the original classic ribbon look or the simplified narrower look. I prefer the simplified look. You can also customize the quick access buttons. Click on the little drop-down arrow in the top left corner and look for more commands. It will open the Quick Access Toolbar menu. My favorite is in All Commands, Meeting Details from Another Day. This will bring up all my meetings from any days, not just today, in a matter of seconds. You'll even see a little calendar here. To create a new notebook, go to File tab and select New. It will ask you where you want to save the file. To make it accessible on all your devices, select the OneDrive option and give it a name. Mine will be Christy's Test Notebook. Then OneNote will ask you if you want to invite more people. That means sharing with others immediately or not now. After this, your new empty notebook is created with one untitled section and one untitled page. If you see little dots next to the section and page, that means unread and can get rid of it by pushing Ctrl Q. You can rename the page by typing anything in the title area and the section too if you click on it and give it a name. Mine will be Project Info. With Ctrl T, you can quickly add sections to your notebook. You can do the same by clicking on the plus button, or if you right-click on an existing section, you can insert another section or even a section group. For example, I want to group all people's dedicated sections in a meeting section group. What's really great about OneNote is that you can drag and drop everything around, so this setup can be easily changed in the future too. John is now under this meeting section group. When you're editing a page on the Home tab, you'll find some text formatting options very similar to Microsoft Word. You can play around, change the font settings. Let me increase the text size, for example. If you want to create a bulleted list, you can do that from the ribbon or using Ctrl plus period button combination. But you can change this to a numbered list too. On the Insert tab, you'll see a bunch of things you can insert. You can add a table after selecting the number of rows and columns. If you have a lot of text, you can make it easier to read with inserting some space. Try the file attachment option, and that can be all sorts of file types. Let me insert this one just for fun. It will ask if you want to attach the file or insert a printout you can annotate. The file printout option is separately available too. The file printout embeds the file and creates a picture from the PDF you selected. You can drag it around or right-click and select Set Picture as Background to keep it in place. Then you can type or draw anything on top of it. Really fun! Going back to Insert tab, you can add the full Excel spreadsheet, pictures from different sources, or you can add the page template as a new page. In the View tab, you'll find some handy options for your page in general. You can add lines or grid lines to the page to help you with typing, handwriting, or just lining up some elements in your notes. I use this feature a lot as I like to have neat notes. You can change the background color of the page to help it stand out. For page color, you'll find some default pastel tones, but you can go as wild as you want with adding some custom colors. On the Draw tab, you'll find some pens and highlighters you can use for your notes. I like to set my pens when starting off with OneNote, as I tend to use the same all the time. Ooh, my mouse writing is a bit wobbly. If I want to create a few standard shapes, I never do that freehand, but rather select the automatic shapes option on the Draw tab. Now you can see why. When I click on automatic shapes and do the same, it will be so much more acceptable. If I don't like the color of the shape, and let's say I want to select more shapes on one page, I can do that with the lasso tool. Then right click, and under pen properties, I select this ocean color. With Ctrl N, I'll create a new page. And this will be my list page that I'll use to be my table of content. I add a few lines here and select all the text. Right click and select Link to Pages. As you can see, the text has changed color and has dashes underneath. That means we have new pages, hyperlinked, with the same title text, but these pages are still empty. Let me add some text on a page. And now, going back to my list, I can see a continuous line under the budget link. To create a link back to my list, I'll add some text. Then push Ctrl K. I can manually look for the page or type here, list, and it's quicker. Another way is to right click on list page in navigation, select copy link to page. Go to another page and Ctrl V, and you'll get the page name as a link text. To change it, again Ctrl K and rewrite the text to display part. I have now a meeting notes page under the John section, and I want to add some structure around my action items. On the Home tab, you'll find the Insert Tags option, the box with a star on top. There are many default tags in here, but you can easily modify or create new ones. For example, you'd like a to-do plus two more to track progress with action items. First, let's modify a tag. I'll just change the display name here to Not Started. Then I'll create a new tag that's in progress, and I'll look for a symbol. This yellow box is fine. To access these quickly, move them up or down with the arrows on the right. You can see that till 9, these are numbered, so you can set keyboard shortcuts. In this case, my to-do list is Ctrl 1, my not started is Ctrl 2. You can have more than one tag assigned for a text. Create one pager. I'll add another in progress task. Update budget for April. To look for these tags and sort them, go to Find Tags next to the Insert Tags button. It will bring up a list on the right side of the page. You can switch between only this notebook or collecting tags from all notebooks. And these tags are also hyperlinked, so you can quickly jump on the page where they are. If I make any changes, for example, finish this task and then refresh my results, this list will change. If you want to reuse a page frequently, for example, this meeting note page, you can turn it into a template. Go to View tab, Paper Size, and at the bottom you'll see Set Current Page as a Template. Mine will be 1-to-1 meetings. Click Save. If I want to create a new page with this layout, I'll go to Insert tab, Page Templates, then Page Templates again, and it will bring up all the templates on the right, and my template will be on top. When you're in a dark room in a conference and want to take notes, to switch between light and dark mode quickly, go to View tab, Switch Background. When you go to Full Page View with the two directional arrow on top right, you'll get a fully black page to work on. To change the whole layout, go to File tab, Options, and on the General tab, you'll find Office Theme options. You can go full dark mode with black, bit of a hybrid is dark gray. Mine is set to the default colorful. Password protection comes in handy when you share your notebook, as you cannot share only selective sections. In this case, either right-click on the section and look for the password protect this section, and then set a password on the right side of the page, or go to Review tab, Password. Sharing a notebook is super easy. There is the Share button on the top right corner, or you can go to File tab and Share. Or under the individual notebook, you'll find Invite People, or in the drop-down under the little notebook icon, Share or Move. And just like that, we've covered the basics of OneNote. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a thumbs up and check out the OneNote versus Outlook integration videos on my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.